I'm gonna keep it. This is actually incredibly awkward. we have Cascade Bluffs and we have no way to actually activate it. But we're on the draw. I think we keep this. This could cycle. We should be able to hit a blue source or a red source. All right, there you go. Ooh, not the best time for experiment one. So we kind of have an awkward collection of mana. The only card that I saw in the draft that I'm really afraid of is Edric. So, ooh, Shardless Agent's also very good. Ooh, Jace Architect of Thought. So he actually has a fairly reasonable start here. Shardless Agent is pretty awesome. Ooh, that was a pretty good draw. Doesn't really help us cast anything. You know, we can choose a Detention Sphere, but there's nothing really worth Detention Sphering. He could definitely play something much larger next turn, which would make us want to Detention Sphere. It's kind of unfortunate that we can cast a Gilded Lotus next turn, but not Detention Sphere. So then we're going to have we're going to have to make the decision between whether or not we want to cast Wall of Reverence. He can cast Pelucranos, which is pretty good. The problem is we actually take a lot of damage, so I'm just trying to avoid getting overrun. So if I cast like a Detention Sphere followed by Wall of Reverence, that should do a pretty good job of holding the fort. But that seems kind of like a spew of a Detention Sphere. So we're going to have 5 mana next turn, yeah. Can we die? So we're going to take like 5 damage next turn, go to 13, then we play R1 threat. If he removes it, then we take a bunch. And our hand is pretty... I'm going to cast a Detention Sphere. I'm going to get the experiment one. Our hand is pretty loaded, so I'm just kind of afraid of getting run over. You know, if he plays a Planeswalker, that's unfortunate, but... Ooh, Basalt Monolith. Followed by a morph. Okay. So that is an Exalted Angel. I could choose to kill the Exalted Angel, but it doesn't really matter. I can just play this and get instant. Yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and play that. It's gonna be really hard for him to actually get through this, so. Yes, I would like to gain life. So he can, you know, send the team, unmorph this, choose to gain his life. I don't really care if he gains life, so. Wall of Reverence does a really good job of just blocking the angel anyways. But it's possible that he just chooses to play something else here. But he also doesn't want to overextend because he saw Wrath effects. So, yeah, that's reasonable too. So now I can just, like, keep the Exalted Angel tapped. I can just go, like, Mind Stone... Yeah, Mind Stone and Johnny, keep the angel tapped. Well, yes, I would like to gain life. Thank you for asking. So now we can attack with both, but that doesn't seem very good for him. Now maybe he drops a Pelucranos. Alright, Pelucranos is actually pretty good. He can't pump it twice. I'm actually considering... Let me see here. I'm considering killing it. What happens if I electrolyze it? Two, and then helix it. Because what happens if he does choose to monstrosity it? He can pump it twice, maybe three if he has another land, making it an 8-8. Then it's going to be really difficult to deal with. I guess if we do have an active Ajani, we can just keep that locked down. But let's see. So if I were to Helix, it would go to two, and then I Electrolyze, and then we can still make a Decree token for one. So like, Wall of Reverence would have to block here. A Decree token for one would have to chump the Shardless Agent. Or we can just keep the Exalted Angel tapped and make a ton of tokens this turn. And by ton, I mean I can make four tokens this turn. I think I like that better. Well, is that better? Or do I want to just play a Gilded Lotus? I can also just choose to lose the Wall of Reverence. No, that's not that great. 3, 4, 5. If I play the Gilded Lotus, however, that's 3, 4, 5. That gives me access to 3, 4. All right, so that gives me access to 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 10, which means I can Decree of Justice for 3 next turn, which seems really strong. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna do that. One, two, three, four, five. So Wall of Reverence is basically just going to chump the Pelucranos. I can choose to Electrolyze the Avacyn's Pilgrim to kind of make it fight for a little bit less. And just cut him off some mana. Or I can choose to kill the Shardless Agent. But I don't think I care about the Shardless Agent as much. So. And if we draw a land, maybe I'll just crack the Mind Stone. So that route was a fairly good draw. This means that, assuming he doesn't have a way to pump the Shardless Agent, you know, he's going to kill the Wall of Reverence here, and then Ajani's going to go to 3. Wait, he just chose not to fight. That doesn't seem like the best. Oh, I see what he can do. Really surprised he didn't do that. Is this correct? Okay. I don't want to cast the Decree of Justice now because I have the route. So I can cast the route at instant speed. And I might do that on his turn. Can he actually, like, 1, 2, 3, 4? Yeah, I'd like to. I think I'm going to let the Johnny go down, too, only because there's a chance that he might just, like, play another creature, you know? And that's probably worth it. Or do I want to keep this higher? Yeah, I'd rather him like waste a turn to use the Pelucranos to kill the Wall of Reverence. Ooh, that's a good one. Can get that bad boy into play at some point. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 4. So if we have 12 mana, we can make 4 guys. Uh-oh. Here it is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. He can have it deal 5 damage, right? I don't even see what that does. Oh, Court of Calling for 6. Uh-oh. Well, it's not Teferi, at least. Alright. Now that he's tapped out, he's got blue mana. Let's just go ahead and ruin his day. Oh, I should have let that resolve first. Let's hope we don't die to one life. And I also should have sacked. God, I am so bad at this game. It's one of those situations where you're ahead and then you just play kind of loose. So, you know, I'm spotting my mistakes, but it's still pretty loose. And I should not be doing it. Like, that could have been huge. Granted, we have a ton of permanents, but... That was really, really loose. So loose. Alright, I'm just going to go ahead and kill Garrick. Hey, he gets transformed. Do I want to play around Daze? Do I just make 9 tokens? No, I want to make angels though. I don't think he's going to play Daze in his 3 color deck. And he has 1 card in hand. Like, yeah. All right. 4 angels. Hope that's good enough. Whoa, that's not bad. Maybe getting back a Frost Titan? I don't know. I'm trying to figure out what the best card in his yard is. It seems like Frost Titan is... maybe it's Polukranos? Does he have the mana to, like, kill something? Okay, so it's Polukranos. So Gargadon should be at 1 lower. I should be at 1 higher life. Ooh, that was pretty good. I mean, he can at this point he can kill. Like, I want to just kill him. So if he takes 16 and then 12, that's just dead. He can like kill one of my angels, but. Let's keep this tapped. Jibber jabbering. All right, that's the match. Yeah, we played a little bit loose. Do apologize, guys. But deck too strong. All right, on to the finals.